creating technical demos is not an easy fit. You need to tell a story and illustrate the value prop of the technology. That's exactly what Philipp from Media Lesson is here to show us with this fancy toy bricks city that he has behind you and that HoloLens on the table. I won't tell you more. That's today on the IoT Show. Hi, everyone. This is the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host. Today, we're going to talk metaverse with a pretty cool demo that Philipp from Media Lesson is joining me to show us and tell us more about. So, Philipp, welcome to the show today. How are you?
Great. How are you? Thanks for having me.
I'm great. Well, thanks for joining. You are calling from far away. Where are you located right now?
I'm in South Germany.
South Germany. Okay. So how's the weather these days? Have some snow there?
It's snowy, actually. We have snow outside.
Yeah, and you have ski resorts not far away, right?
That's right.
Okay, Philipp. So before we jump into the demo and your explanations about how you use some toy bricks to showcase platforms to interact with an environment like a smart city. But before we jump into that, Philipp, who are you? Who is Media Lesson, the company you work with, and what are you doing?
Yeah, hi. I founded Media Lesson exactly 20 years ago, almost to the day. We are a small consultancy focusing on the Microsoft platform. So we're doing all things Azure software development, including a heavy focus on IoT. And also, as you will see later, focus on storytelling as well. Besides that, I do interact a lot with the community. I've been Microsoft MVP for 10 years now and also Microsoft Regional Director for 5 years.
Yeah, we can see the frames behind you, all these MVP titles. You're the deal, right? And interestingly, what we want to focus on today is your ability to do the storytelling and helping companies, you know, showcasing what they can do with their final solutions. But you are also doing integration of these IoT plus cloud services for helping your customers getting to business. But you know, I think showcasing how you can help them showcase their solution is a great way of explaining, you know, your expertise in that domain. So tell me a bit more about the inception of what we're going to see in a minute, which is a full blown city built with, toy bricks that have sensors and so on. So I'll let you just introduce the inception of that demonstration and showcase.
Yeah, so actually I have the city right behind me, so I'm going to switch cameras now. So you got to see. I turned out my office lights, so you can see it's actually there's lights inside. So it's a city that is alive. The idea is to explain the industrial metaverse. So how companies can actually use the metaverse to visualize and reason about IoT data within their companies.
And what's interesting is that this kind of scenarios are being developed and built and deployed now, but it's hard to find an actual smart city today where you can leverage an infrastructure that's already in place to demonstrate the capabilities of a platform, right? So hence using toy bricks to do that.
Exactly. So Microsoft approached us to help them tell a story around how you can use the HoloLens as a mixed reality device to look at data in a very different way, actually in a way where data is visualized at the context where the data comes from. So if you have data that originates from a sensor of a valve or any other machinery or equipment, you don't want to see it on your tablet and then find that specific part. You want to actually see the error or the telemetry data that you want to look at the origin of that data. And that's what HoloLens is enabling for us.
Yeah. And what looks very much like science fiction or futuristic, you know, things, as you'll demo like real soon or showcase now, are things that are real. I mean, and the objective of using some fancy tool like in a HoloLens is actually not so fancy. It's really about bringing, as you were describing, the data to the operator in context. And very often the operator is not someone who is like software, you know, able or expert, and so they need to be able to access that information. Sometimes they have big gloves, sometimes they are doing something else, sometimes they don't know, you know, how to navigate a database, right? And so exposing the data in context makes their job way easier and more efficient and allows them to focus on the task at hand versus trying to find that information that led them to have a ticket created and for them to be on that site to repair something or something like that, right?
Exactly. And so because, you know, we don't have an entire city that we can just walk around for demo purposes, we had to come up with an idea to have a small scale model that can travel along with trade shows and other events to actually explain how this meta idea of the metaverse unfolds.
Yeah. So enough teasing. Let's look at the pictures you brought off. You know, we've seen the city behind you. Yes. Now show us a bit more about how it's been built and what's in there.
Yeah, so initially we had just 10 days to pull this off from actually this picture you're currently looking at. So we started with not on the green field, but on the gray brick field and to create a scenario on top of it. So basically we just started ordering bricks as much as we could. And by the way, we're using a total of 35,000 bricks in this demo. And then we started, you know, landscaping a little bit, and we came to a point where we wanted to have water. And obviously we cannot have real water, and we don't just want to have plastic water. So we added a old surface tablet to display some water. So there's even, you know, a form of metaverse in the physical space as well. And then obviously we went on building more and more. So we had a whole team working day and night, building all sorts of models of cities and buildings and stuff until we came to this point where we have a whole city. So there's shops and restaurants and hotels. There's a clinic on top of it. And there are different sources of power. So we have a water plant that was this little water lake. We have a windmill on top of it and some solar plants because the story we're telling is about how energy can be created, renewable energy can be created and distributed in a city with different weather. So you can simulate weather situations with clouds, no clouds, and see how the city gets lighter or darker depending on how much power is available.
Okay, well, that's becoming interesting. Actually, you're in the core of, besides the fancy aspect of it, you're in the core of the actual real life scenarios, and now you're able in that dimension to illustrate them and demo them. So you have some actual demos of you know a HoloLens. So, like, carry on, man. I just don't want to stop you there.
So, I mean, the next step is we wanted to have the digital overlay on our physical model, right? That's the core idea of the industrial metaverse, is that we use services like Azure Digital Twins and, of course, the HoloLens to overlay a physical world with a digital world. And to have that in place, we wanted to be precise. Like, you look at it and you instantly see data. And to do that, we need to have a digital 3D model of our physical model. So we modeled in a brick designer tool the whole thing again. So another 35,000 bricks, this time modeled virtually to be an exact twin, 3D twin of that model. And then we feed this 3D data into Azure Object Anchors, which is an Azure service that allows you to create a mapping of a physical object so you can overlay precisely on top of it.
Okay.
And then we added some IoT devices to the game. So in our Lego model, you can see it as a little network switch, but there's also a IoT gateway, professional industrial IoT gateway, so we can control all the lights in the city, but we can also turn on and off the windmill and adjust the solar panels and things like that. So we can actually not only collect data, but also action in the physical model.
And what's interesting here is that you're close to the reality of things, because these sensors, these actuators, they're of a certain type because you're manipulating toy bricks here. But it's the exact same kind of data and ways of connecting to the Azure cloud that you're going to be using in actual production. And so you are basically just replicating what's going to happen in real life after.
Exactly. And then, I mean, on top of it, it's also about details to make the thing come to life. So because we're doing this for Microsoft and for Azure, we added lots of little bits of branding to the model, so you can actually see what this story is all about. So there's some city lights in here, and We also even added a special mode for after hours in the trade show. So in German trade shows, it's in the after hours, there's always a booth party, right, going on. So we wanted to have that as well. So I don't know if you can see here the audio.
We can see and hear, yes.
Okay, all right. So if you say disco in the model, it starts doing this. I don't know if you're allowed to use the music, by the way, so just so sorry for
Yeah, we're fine. We're fine there. We're fine there. That is pretty cool. That is pretty cool. I think you're pushing. And what is fantastic, actually, I want to go back to your ability of telling stories, right? What you just described here, and we'll go back to that real quick after, but you not only are implementing a showcase of real-life solution in a way that is visual, that is understandable by different types of audiences, because a technical person will come in here and start asking questions about how do the device, you know, connect and communicate, and someone else will say, okay, the value of all of that is what? Hey, you see energy production and consumption, you know, adapting to weather, adapting to environment conditions. So this is really, and then the fun part, which will trigger the conversation during that after event party about the actual solutions. I think in terms of storytelling, you're just like checking all the boxes. That's pretty fantastic. So I want to go back to and maybe you have planned that. So you created the physical environment, right? You created a virtual representation, a graphical model, right? A twin in the sense of a 3D rendering. There's also another twin, which is the twin, which is the different, I wouldn't say, different things. They're represented in form of data with set of properties and relationships, which is hosted in Azure Digital Twins as a service. So that's something that's going to be used, right, for overlaying the data on the visual twin.
Exactly. So this is the next thing we're going to look at, is how it actually feels once you put on the HoloLens. Because right now we just saw the physical model, which is interesting to look at. But now you want to put on the HoloLens and dive into that digital model.
Yep.
So I brought a little simulation of that. And so this is what you will see when you actually wear a HoloLens. So I'm going to jump to a different set here. So you can see here now, there's your dashboard overlay that you can see. It's going to move it away in a second, pin it over here. And you can see the physical model of the city is now overlaid with all sorts of information and graphics. So we have different dashboard information about the power consumption, and we can now tweak the weather. You can see now cloudiness, and we can toggle on and off solar source, for example, and see how much power is generated from that source. You can now even see the sun rays coming down here. And you can see the city is very dark at the moment. And once we turn on the wind and energy, and we're going to do that in a second here, toggle wind. So you can now see the physical windmill is now turning. So it acts back into the physical model as well. And we can now see the lights in the city get brighter and brighter as there's more energy generated. So this is the experience you get when you wear the HoloLens.
Nice. And once again, here we're talking about something that is very, you know, appealing. But then that translates directly into, you know, different types of operators, because then you're gonna have an opportunity to filter out what the operator sees and what they can interact with, you know, in that 3D augmented reality visualization, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, pretty fantastic. And all of that is possible and backed up, because once again, this is not just a video demo of one thing that has been baked. Here, you can very easily replace the data of that dashboard, precipitation levels and so on, with data coming from sensors. Like you would have wind sensors, you would have light sensors, you would have water sensors that will give you that information instead of having a simulated dashboard here.
Yes. So that the little knobs on the dashboard, therefore, to play around, right? Yep. But there's a little map of Germany left to it. You can see this here. And you can move the pin around that map, and it pulls the actual weather data from that location and presets it. So you can also show the interaction with real data as well.
Yeah, and I want to put the focus once again on your storytelling skills, because here you're addressing, you know, different types of audiences, and you're going to tell them, hey, where do you live? Let's put the pin on your city and see, you know, how it applies to your city here. I like that.
Yes. In the meantime, we did also a French version for Microsoft Envision in Paris right before Christmas, and they obviously had a French map. That's awesome.
So, Philipp, there's one thing that I didn't mention once, but we didn't dig into, and we won't, because I'm pretty happy we're not going into that level of details today. So Azure Digital Twins is this PaaS service that is leveraged to build solutions that simplifies how you can integrate data from different sources, visualize things, that data in context by having this graph, allows you to have different things, put in relationships and so on. So you're not mentioning that much, but that's okay, because at the end of the day, what we do want is for customers and people to realize that this complexity is abstracted thanks to these services, and that the ability for someone to focus on the value add, which is the operator experience, which is the augmentation of scenarios thanks to data coming from different sources, et cetera. These are the things we want to highlight and we want to illustrate here during this kind of showcases, right?
Exactly. For me, that's the magic of Azure. Is you it's almost all the time about composing different services in a new and innovative way that helps to solve problems in almost no time. I mean, we built the entire thing in just under 10 days in front of at the first show, and that wouldn't have been possible if we had to take care of infrastructure and data sources and connecting stuff. But we could focus on our use case and just orchestrate or compose it out of existing Azure services.
Yeah. So I will bring up here a link, which is ak.ms/IoT show/media lesson for people who want to learn more about what's going on here. You should realize that people's going to start reaching out and applying here, because we have a bunch of people interested in IoT, in the metaverse story, and in these toy bricks that you guys are playing with. And when we saw your team, you know, building that demo, it was a job. That was not just for fun, right?
It was a fun project, though, so for sure.
That's awesome. So I hope you're going to get way more of this kind of projects coming up, because you are doing a very good job at not just the storytelling once again, also at the integration of these services. 10 days to not just put together that toy bricks model together, but also all the software that is behind is definitely a fit. It's definitely something that is not easy, but is made simpler thanks to hopefully the services that we provide. So I really appreciate your time here, Philipp. I look forward to your next big showcase so that we can bring you back here and have some more fun.
Thank you, Olivier, for having me.